Good evening and welcome to my whiskey channel, the Whiskey Lover Society. I grew up in South Africa by the accent, and I grew up always having some type of form of whiskey in the house. My dad used to like drinking some different types of whiskies. And of course, growing up in South Africa, we did not have a huge variety of whiskies. So, as the first episode, I'm just going to take you through to some of the whiskies that I grew up with. Whiskies that you might know, whiskies that you might have never heard of. And I was sitting thinking about all the whiskies that my dad was drinking, the type of whiskies, and I was making up a short little list of some of the whiskies that I can remember. Some of them stood out. Some of the whiskies was well known in South Africa. The variety in South Africa was of course not huge, but I will have a quick rundown of some of the whiskies that we had. And the first one that stood out for me was the Inverness Cream. And I was always looking at the name and looking at cream, and I was thinking something, some milky, ice cream, sweet. Of course, the reality in some of the whiskey names is definitely not compatible with what is on the inside. So this was my first whiskey that I tasted, probably at the age of 16, 17. I remember going into my dad's whiskey cabinet and taking a little sip of each or different type of whiskey that he had. And I always remember, how on earth can somebody drink something that is so disgusting? But anyway, that was the first one that I ever tasted, the Inverness Cream. Of course, during the years, palates taste. And the next one on the agenda was the Knight's Whiskey. And I don't know much of it. I cannot really much recall on what the taste of it. But I do recall that I did not like it. So I went a little bit online and I had a look at what they were saying about this whiskey that was made in South Africa. So Knight's Whiskey, they call it the finest matured whiskey, sophisticated yet uncomplicated and playful. It's a genuine international whiskey matured for 3 years at the James Sedgwick Distillery in South Africa. Knight's is blended. Knight's is a blend of the finest malt and grain whiskey, matured in oak barrels to give a full character with a slight sweet palate made for your enjoyment. As far as I can remember, that was definitely not the best whiskey that I've ever tasted. The next whiskey on the list is the Two Keys Whiskey. Two Keys Whiskey was quite popular in South Africa, and I think it was more with regards to the pricing than anything else. And I know this was a company called Edward Snell and Company. It is one of the big distributors of whiskies, alcohol, all different types of spirits and wines within South Africa, and still is. It's also a blended scotch, and with 14 different malt whiskies, so they really do blend them. It's malt whiskies coming from the Highland regions of Scotland. A grain component distilled on the banks of the Loch Lomond. Description on the website many years ago was the finest reserve whiskey. Exhibits notes of burnt coffee, hints of cereal. It has a strong spirit taste, and that I can clearly remember tasted like window cleaner to me, with a subtle but noticeable sweetness, which I cannot remember till today. The next whiskey that I can remember with not fond memories was the First Watch whiskey. And as I remember, this is still available in South Africa. I think that is the one of the cheapest whiskies that's still available. It's something that you definitely don't want to taste. It's not something that you will ever want to buy. Not even to use it in a cocktail. So that's something that I've always tried to avoid. But of course, if the money is running low and you do need to have something for your party, yeah, you might as well try it. But it's best to buy this to clean windows and definitely not to drink. The next one was a little bit of an upscale whiskey. And that's something that we not often had in the house. But I know every now and again my dad would get a nice gift from a friend, and that was the Johnny Walker Red Label. And you must also understand in South Africa that Johnny Walker was quite a popular whiskey. It was a little bit more expensive than the normal whiskey. So if you do have an opportunity to go a little bit up in the whiskey market, of course, Johnny Walker Red Label was the first one that people started selecting. Today, my palate, I think, is completely changed. Johnny Walker Red Label is one of the whiskies that I look back at, and today I would not even try to buy it. Of course, the next one, the Black Label, was also in the market. And it was a completely different type of whiskey. It was a better tasting whiskey, a little bit matured whiskey, with an age statement of 12 years old. So that was a little bit mellowed out. It didn't have that sharp spirit type of burn to it. So for me, that was the first real whiskey that I had as a young guy from about 18 years old. So that became my go-to whiskey. Every time I did have the necessary money to buy some whiskey, I would have gone with the Black Label, and it was quite a entertaining whiskey for me. Of course, the unobtainable, not all whiskies in South Africa was the cheap ones, and I think everybody was looking at the gold standard of whiskies, and that was for me the Johnny Walker Blue Label. And I think today also the Johnny Walker Blue Label is a whiskey that a lot of people would say is some of the best. I remember going to a restaurant in South Africa a couple of years ago, and they had a bottle of Johnny Walker Blue Label, and I inquired about the price for a double, and it was just in plain incredible. I remember thinking, for that double of Johnny Walker Blue Label, I could buy at least two bottles of Johnny Walker Red Label. So of course, that bottle was standing in that pub for many, many years. Nobody actually bought anything with regards to the Johnny Walker Blue Label. And then of course, I think the ultimate, and maybe not that the more expensive, or the next one, I remember years ago, I was invited to some friend's house, and my friend's dad was also a whiskey drinker, and I was offered a Chivas Regis 12-year-old whiskey, and I was thinking that this is the type of whiskey that I would like to have in the future. Fantastic tasted much stronger than the ABV. I remember sitting on a porch sipping this whiskey, and I'm thinking by myself, this is must be the best whiskey that I've ever tasted. Boy, was I wrong. And then the last one that I would also like to talk about, and this is something that my dad had in his cabinet, was the Dimple whiskey. And I still see it today, quite popular as well. And for me, that was so nice to see the Dimple. While I was at the airport not so long ago at the lounge, and we had a Dimple. So that really took me back to the days when sneaking in my dad's cabinet, having a quick sip of the whiskey, and then realizing he could see that maybe there was less in the bottle, and we just top it up with a little bit of water. And I think eventually my dad's whiskey was not 40-45% ABV. I think it was more like 34-35% ABV. To finish off this first episode, I am going to do a little bit of tasting. And I'm going to start off my tasting with my favorite whiskey. Well, one of my favorite whiskeys. The Macallans. I do like my Macallans. And the first Macallan that I want to taste is the Macallan Gold Double Cask. Matured in hand-picked, sherry-seasoned American and European oak casks. Bottled at 40%, so it barely makes the legal requirements with regards to whiskey at 40% ABV. And I think it is a lot to do with marketing. Macallan has been known for excellent marketing. You will find them quite often in a lot of movies where they talk about the Macallan. And I think due to the excellent marketing, also it reflects in the price. Macallan can be quite expensive. This one, I'm not sure about the price. I bought this whiskey about 2 years ago. I still have some left. If you look at the color, it's a nice light gold color. But I do love the smell. A lot of woody notes in this one. And I suspect that has got something to do with the European oak that do tend to make things a little bit on that bitter, dry side. So the wood notes are definitely there. A little bit of vanilla. I like the vanilla. It's also quite sweet smell to it. A little bit, a little raisins maybe. It reminds me of apple cider, hard apple cider, something like Bowman's or in South Africa, Hunter's Dry type of apple cider. And a little bit of marmalade to it, a little bit of a bitter note. On the taste, funny thing about Macallan whiskey is that the nose and taste can be very different. If you look at the notes that I made with regards to the nose of it, you had that sweet, this nice raisiny vanilla flavors coming through, the apple cider, hard apple cider coming through. The marmalade, the sweeter smell, but as soon as you taste it, that disappears, and I get the sweet still there, but when the bitter oak, probably from the European cask, come in, it does create a bitter taste in your mouth, you do still get a little bit of the sweet, maybe burnt caramel or anything in that direction. But it does feel like all the lovely notes just disappears and leaving you with more bitter notes than anything else. So do I like it? Yes, I do it. I think I've become I think I've been acclimatizing to this whiskey. I think I'm getting used to some whiskeys with a little bit of a bitter note to them. Is it my favorite Macallan? Absolutely not. I think if we look at my favorite ones, you're looking at a 12-year-old or maybe the 18-year-old Macallan. For me, that was a little bit more rounded off. Also, the idea of paying a premium for a 40% ABV whiskey is also a little bit ridiculous. I think it they are riding on their name. You are paying for a name and not just what's in the bottle. So thank you very much for listening to my first episode. And I hope that you enjoyed it. Please like and subscribe and help me to get my first 100 people to subscribe. Thank you very much.